What's going on, growers? It's James Prigioni coming to you live from Jersey. Today, me and Tuck want to show you a super invasive pest that has infested our garden with its eggs and share with you how to remove them before they hatch into a bigger problem. Let's go! While I was out pruning my fruit trees, I noticed something peculiar on them. And after doing a little bit of research, I found out that this right here is an egg mass from what's known as the spotted lanternfly. And if you live on the east coast of the United States or in India, China, or Vietnam, your garden might be infested with these egg masses as well. Each egg mass contains between 30 and 50 eggs, so it's important that we remove as many as possible before they hatch in spring. Fortunately, they're really simple to remove. The egg masses are also easy to identify. I have found most of them on the underside of the branches of my trees. They're this light gray color with a mud-like covering over it. The older egg masses change color to a light tan and resemble cracking mud. If you see an egg mass with no covering on it, then the eggs may have already hatched. They don't just lay their eggs on trees though, they'll lay their eggs on almost anything outside. Lawn furniture, rocks, even cars. Now, me and Tuck are going to move through the food forest and get rid of these eggs. To do that, we'll need a few simple household items. First, we'll need something to scrape off the egg masses. For this, a simple rigid card works great. A putty knife works too, but I've found that the rigid card works even better. Second, we'll need something to scrape the egg masses into. A simple plastic bag works fantastic for this. Third, we'll need something to put in the plastic bag to make sure we destroy the eggs when they go inside of it. Rubbing alcohol works great for this, and you could also use hand sanitizer. Just make sure it at least has 60% alcohol in it. Let's go over to the cherry tree, identify some more egg masses, and remove them from the tree. So right over here, I showed you this one over here earlier. Right here we have another one on the same tree. Typically they're about an inch long and almost 3/4 of an inch wide. So what we want to do is get our bag all set up nicely underneath it, and then we'll scrape this right into the bag. You want to do this on a day that's not windy to make sure you're getting all the egg masses in the bag. As you can see, we've got a lot of the eggs in here, just like we wanted from that egg mass. Now we're gonna go around and just scrape a bunch more into this bag. I removed all the ones I could identify on the cherry tree. Now I'm looking at this hazelnut and I'm seeing a bunch. There's one right here, another one right next to us right here, and then even another one right here. So these things are just everywhere. We wanna get rid of as many as we possibly can though. If you want, you could also use your card and crush the egg masses. The thing is, you just have to make sure you're crushing these. You can hear the sound, and I think this is just a little bit less of an effective method than actually scraping them into a bag with some hand sanitizer or some alcohol in them. Let's crush this one too. For the egg masses that you're unable to reach, I wouldn't suggest getting up on a ladder and crushing them. You could use something like pure neem oil. This is a good option, and it's said to kill about 75% of the eggs. Just make sure you really coat them when you're spraying them, and mix this with some water and some dish soap. The spotted lanternfly's favorite tree is the tree of heaven, but it also loves grapes. It will go after your vegetables, your fruit trees, and like 70 other species. So almost no garden or plant is safe from these ugly pests. Last year, I saw the nymphs of the spotted lanternflies on my grapes. They were just covered. They have black bodies with little white spots. Then later in the season, I saw the adults along my grapevines just covered as well. So this year, I'll be sure to spray them down with some neem oil. I want to show you a section of my apple tree right here that is absolutely covered with these egg masses. The thing is, this apple tree is right next to my grapes, so I want to make sure I eradicate as many of these as possible. The spotted lanternfly is a plant stressor, so it's unlikely to kill your trees or plants on its own. But in combination to other stressors, like bad weather or disease, it can cause significant damage. And it has been known to kill some young saplings of the tree of heaven and even some young grapevines. This little guy is out here exploring, having a blast. He's been looking for some carrots. He's trying to feast, get some snacks. Every time I turn my back, this guy's digging, getting into something. Yeah, he's a boss, he's a pretty good guy. Make sure you hit the like button if you love seeing Tuck in the videos. And also, check out the Tuck merch down at jamesprigioni.com. Grab a sweatshirt, grab a t-shirt, and just be part of Team Grow and, you know, support the boss. Because there's a reason he's the boss, there's a reason he's the leader. He's always out here, he's dedicated, he's the true guardian of the garden, and you always gotta pay the Tuck tax by giving him just a few carrots. The spotted lanternfly starts laying its eggs from September and all the way up to like December. So anytime after that, you can go out and start removing them from your trees or anywhere else you find them. And they don't hatch usually till spring, around April time. So get out there now and start removing as many as you can. It's unrealistic to think that just removing the egg masses will make it so you don't see any in your garden the next year, but just knowing what they are and how to manage them will greatly help reduce the growing population. When you're pruning your fruit trees or just out working in the garden, it's always a good idea to remain alert. Look over the trees to see if you could find any issues with the tree, maybe some egg masses, or even something like a praying mantis nest. The first time I saw a praying mantis nest, I thought it was a pest. Then after doing some research, I realized that this is a great beneficial insect. It's an insectivore that will feast on some of the soft-bodied pests in your garden. So don't just panic if you see some kind of nest. Go inside, try to find out what it is, identify it, and then make a decision on whether or not you should remove it. That's today's video, growers. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you got something out of it. I hope me and Tuck, the little boss, encourage you to get out there and remove some of these egg masses from your garden to help stop the spread of this invasive pest. It's not fun going out to your grapevines and just seeing these ugly, giant, spotted lanternflies just covered on your grapes. It hurts the grapes, it hurts the trees, and it's just nasty with their big, ugly red eyes. It's not something we like. Me and Tuck wanted to mention to grab some of the merch down at jamesprigioni.com. Support Team Grow. We also want to send a thank you to one of our new channel members, Adam Paris. Thanks for being a part of Team Grow. Thanks for having your hand in everything we're doing back here. James and Tuck will be back at you again real soon. We